Did you know that our universe is so big that we cannot really approximate its actual size? Due to the extremely fast rate of the cosmological expansion, scientists came up with a term called the observable universe, which is by definition a spherical region containing all the matter that can be observed from telescopes on Earth, and the space-based probes or even the exploratory probes such as Voyager 1 and 2, whose main objective is to extend the NASA exploration of the solar system beyond the neighborhood of the outer planets to the outer limits of the Sun's sphere of influence, and possibly beyond. The radius of the observable universe is approximately 46.508 billion years. Can you imagine how big it actually is? Bearing in mind that it's not even the actual size of the universe. Now that you can imagine how our universe is extremely big, it's easy to grasp that it's filled with massive objects. Curious to know these objects in order? Keep watching. Prior to stating the list of the most massive objects in the universe, it's crucial to understand the concept of mass along with the astronomical mass units. Mass, by definition, is the measure of the amount of matter in an object, usually measured in grams or kilograms. However, due to the difficulties in measuring and expressing astronomical data in the International System of Units, SI units, the Astronomical System of Units was developed in 1979, in which there was a redefinition of units of mass, time and length, and the astronomical constants as well. The astronomical unit of mass is the solar mass, aka the mass of the Sun, which is approximately equal to 1.98892 times 10 to the power of 30 kilograms, and it is the standard unit of describing the mass of stars and galaxies. When it comes to cosmology, the term object is a loose concept because the universe is filled up with so many objects, such as planets, stars, black holes, and pulsars. However, one must ask, is any structure of gravitationally bound matter considered to be an object? If the answer is yes, then we must consider nebula, galaxies, galaxy clusters, and the clusters of the galaxy clusters as objects as well. Moreover, we should consider the cosmic web, which is an overarching structure that holds all the matter in the universe as an object. Therefore, in this video, we are introducing the most massive objects in the universe, covering most of their types in descending order. Number 10. As you probably know, the most massive object in the universe from the beginning of time is the universe itself, right before the moment of the Big Bang. The Big Bang model states that the universe at the beginning, 13.7 billion years ago, was in an extremely hot and dense state. Just try to imagine the total mass of the universe condensed into an extremely infinitesimally small point-like singularity. Number 9. Dark energy, which constitutes 68% of the universe. You may wonder how on Earth would energy be massive? But thanks to Einstein's energy-mass famous equation, E equals mc squared, where c is the speed of light, transforming energy into mass is trivial. You may also have heard of the dark energy previously, but let me explain its importance in detail. Scientists in the early 1990s were fairly certain about some dynamics of the universe's expansion, such that it might have enough energy density to stop its expansion and recollapse, or it might have so little energy that it would never stop expanding. However, the gravitational forces were certain to slow the expansion as time went on, due to the fact that our universe is full of matter and the attractive force of gravity pulls all matter together. However, in 1998, the Hubble Space Telescope, HST, observations of very distant supernova showed that a long time ago, the universe was actually expanding more slowly than it is today. In other words, the expansion of the universe has not been slowing down due to gravity, as everyone expected, but it has been accelerating, and something was causing this acceleration. Eventually, theorists still do not know what the correct explanation is, but they have given the solution a name. It's called the dark energy. More is unknown than is known about dark energy. The amount of dark energy is known because we know how it influences the universe's expansion. There are three possible explanations of dark energy. One explanation is that it's a property of space. Yes, space has many amazing properties, many of which are just beginning to be understood. Einstein was the first to realize that empty space can possess its own energy. Furthermore, it's possible for more space to come into existence. And because this energy is a property of space itself, it would not be diluted as the space expands. Additionally, as more space comes into existence, more of this space energy will appear, which will be the reason that the universe will expand faster and faster. Unfortunately, there are some issues regarding this fancy model and related to the cosmological constant. Another explanation of how space acquires energy comes from the quantum theory of matter, which states that empty space is full of temporal particles that are continuously formed and then disappear via annihilation. Yet the total number of these virtual particles is not consistent with the ratio of the dark energy. The last explanation for dark energy is that it's a new kind of dynamical energy fluid or field, which can be considered as something that fills all of space, but its effects on the expansion of the universe is the opposite of that of matter and normal energy. In conclusion, scientists need more and better data to decide between these models. Number 8. Dark matter, which constitutes 27% of the universe. Observations made us much more certain about what dark matter is not than what it actually is. First, it's called dark because it's not in the form of stars and planets we observe every day. Observations show that there's far too little visible matter in the universe to make up the 27% required by the observations. Second, dark matter is not in the form of dark clouds of normal matter. Matter is made up of baryons, and we are aware of this because we would be able to detect baryonic clouds by their absorption of the radiation passing through them. Finally, we are 100% certain that dark matter is not the same as antimatter due to the fact that we don't observe the unique gamma rays that are produced when antimatter annihilates with baryonic matter. However, there are still a few viable possibilities regarding dark matter, one of which is that baryonic matter could still make up the dark matter if it all were concentrated in brown dwarfs or in small dense chunks of heavy elements, which are known as MACHOs, the massive compact halo objects. On the other hand, there's a most common view which states that dark matter is not baryonic at all, but it's made up of more exotic particles like axions or WIMPs, the weakly interacting massive objects. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve our content and make these videos better for you. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Number 7. According to a study published by the Los Alamos National Laboratory, the most massive object in the universe is calculated to be a cluster of galaxies with a total mass equal to 3.8 times 10 to the power of 15 solar masses. The study also states that the Abel 2163 and Abel 370 clusters are viable candidates for the most massive clusters in the universe. These findings motivate further observations, and further surveys will explore larger volumes. Therefore, it's highly possible that the most massive object in the universe may be identified within the next decade. Number 6. As far as the astronomers know, the most massive galaxies in the universe contain approximately 5 times 10 to the power of 11 solar masses of material. Our galaxy, the Milky Way, for comparison, has a total mass of roughly about 10 to the power of 11 solar masses. Typically, about 80% of the mass in the galaxy is in the form of stars, and most of the rest is gas. Not to mention that the astronomers are really trying to understand how galaxies of all types form. In particular, they are interested in the giants, because they appear to exist in the early universe. Our universe is about 13.7 billion years old, and the Milky Way, along with other galaxies in our neighborhood, benefited from having all that time to grow larger. However, some of the most massive galaxies have been found back when the universe was only a few billion years old. The question is, how did they get to be so big so fast? A partial answer to this question can be found by looking at the production of new stars in a galaxy, as well as the growth of its central massive black hole. Luckily, both of these processes can be studied in distant objects since they produce bright radiation in the infrared, with the latter process also producing strong radio and X-ray emission. Number 5. When it comes to single objects, the most massive single object in the universe is the S500014+81 supermassive black hole, which was discovered in 1981. It's about 12.07 billion light years from Earth, located precisely near the high declination region of the constellation Cephas. The mass of this supermassive black hole is approximately 40 billion solar masses. You may ask yourself, how big of a star would S500014+81 have been before it turned into a black hole? However, it is a question based on the wrong premise that supermassive black holes originate from stars that turned into a black hole. And they actually don't. In fact, there's a limit to the mass of any star, which is approximately 200 solar masses. Above that certain limit, a star would not be stable and lose any additional mass to the surrounding space. Therefore, black holes like S500014+81 probably formed from a cluster of several hundred stellar black holes, each of which is no larger than 50 solar masses, that collide and form a single medium-sized black hole with a mass of a few thousand solar masses. On reaching that stage, they start to grow by accreting nearby materials, such as dust, gas, and dark matter, to grow very quickly into supermassive black holes. Number 4. The most massive black hole in our galaxy is known as Sagittarius A-Star. Its mass is estimated at 4.1 times 10 to the power of 6 solar masses. It's located in the center of the Milky Way, which makes it almost a quasar. Findings show that it's 26,000 light years away from us, and it's 44 million kilometers in diameter, which is approximately the same distance between the Sun and Mercury. These numbers are very large for a black hole, since they are extremely dense and occupy less volume. When it comes to observations, it's not visible to the naked eye, which is a trivial fact, since black holes don't let light escape. Additionally, it was very hard for scientists to discover it and gather data due to the huge dust between Earth and the center of our galaxy where it is located. Number 3. The most massive star known to exist in the universe is the star R136A1, which is more than 265 solar masses. Astronomers are still trying to understand how this star can even exist, due to the mass limit of stars. In addition to being the most massive, it is also the most luminous at nearly 9 million times the luminosity of our Sun. It's part of a supercluster in the Tarantula Nebula of the Large Magellanic Cloud, which happens to be the location of some other massive stars in the universe. Number 2. UY Scuti is the most massive star in the Milky Way, with mass approximately equal to 30 solar masses. However, it's not distinct because of its mass only, but also because of its large radius, which is estimated to be 1,700 times the radius of the Sun. Therefore, this single star is so large that its outer surface will extend far beyond the orbit of the planet Jupiter, that lies about 5 times further from the Sun than the Earth. Number 1. On narrowing our scope to be the solar system instead of the whole universe, we will find that Jupiter is the most massive planet in the solar system, with mass equals to 0.001 solar masses, that is 317.8 times the mass of Earth. Its mass is so big that it actually equals 2.5 the mass of all the other planets of the solar system combined. Jupiter is also called a failed star, due to the fact that it is made of the same elements as stars, which are hydrogen and helium. However, it's not massive enough to have the internal pressure and temperature necessary to cause the hydrogen to fuse to helium in a process called hydrogen fusion, which is the energy source that powers the Sun and the other stars during the main sequence of their lifetime. Thanks for watching, everyone. Do you know other comparable massive objects in the universe? Can you guess what other processes that support the star at the end of its main sequence? Did you learn anything new in this video? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.